The video game news is flowing, folks, and there are three stories that I want to talk about from this weekend and today, Monday, that I think are very interesting. No, we're not going to talk about Ninja and Twitch and all that drama going on there. That's not really interesting to me. I'm here to talk about the actual games and what's going on in the world of gaming. Is Analog coming out with a brand new handheld system? And Analog is a company that you definitely need to keep your eye on. A major Nintendo Switch game looks like it's going to be coming out very soon, and I want to tell you guys why I'm excited for this. And GameStop is finally embracing retro in store. There's some new pictures floating around the internet from Spawnwave, and it's something I definitely want to talk about because I think this could be a step in the right direction for the company. So sit back, relax, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and let's get into these stories.
Hey, RGT85. Hey, Sean.
Oh my God, it's Stevie Richards! So if you're a retro game connoisseur, the name Analog should be second nature to you. It's a company that has been releasing various systems and has been doing a fantastic job with them. There was the Analog system for the NES, the Analog system for the Super Nintendo, and of course, the recent Analog Mega SG. Now, I actually picked up an Analog Mega SG, and I've been playing it, but I never did a review on it for some reason. I'm not sure why. I was very late to the party. I had to purchase mine. I wasn't cool enough to get one sent to me by Analog, but I absolutely love this thing. It is arguably the best way to play your Sega Genesis games. You can do so much stuff with it as well. Of course, there's different things that you can hack into the system. You can play games off of SD cards if you choose to do that. But even if you just want to play your cartridge collection, it is the best way to play it on your HD television. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's a phenomenal system, and Analog has always done very well. It looks like Analog is doing more, though, and there's some new patents that have been discovered by my buddy Bob over at RetroRGB, who also runs a YouTube channel. Make sure you check out Bob's channel. I'll have a link to it in the description box down below. But these new patents from Analog actually are showing that there's some new systems coming out. Analog has applied for two new patents, the first one being Analog Pocket. So a lot of people are thinking that this could potentially be a Game Boy system that could potentially play Game Boy, Game Boy Color, maybe even Game Boy Advance games. Now that would be absolutely fantastic because obviously when you're talking about the Game Boy, it has such a vast library. Even if you're just talking about the standard Game Boy, there was so much you could do with the standard Game Boy, especially with things like the Super Game Boy that you could hook up to your Super Nintendo, and some games actually had Super Game Boy specific features in them, which is actually a video I want to do in the future and really show off the power of the Super Game Boy. But being able to access those features in a handheld system could be very good, and I think that's something that Analog would look to do if this is potentially a Game Boy system. A lot of people are speculating what systems it's going to play if it is a Pocket system. I could definitely see it at least playing Game Boy and Game Boy Color games. Game Boy Advance may be further down the line. They may want to do a dedicated system to that, but I would definitely be interested to see what Analog is able to do, considering their track record and how pixel perfect and just how everything looks when it comes to Analog products. I think that could be very exciting. Another system that's in development is called the Analog 8, and we absolutely have no idea what this system is about, but you gotta think it's gotta be something beyond the Sega Genesis. They've obviously done the NES, the Super Nintendo, and the Sega Genesis. So what do they have up their sleeve now? What's the next system they're looking to conquer? Could it be a disc-based system, or will it be sticking with cartridges? Could it potentially be an N64 system? Obviously, N64 stuff is hot right now. You have the N64 Eon adapter. You have the system coming out from Hyperkin. So if it's an N64 system, that could be an absolute game changer, especially when you look at what Analog is able to do in terms of the other retro systems that they've worked on so far. There's definitely a lot of speculation, definitely a lot of things up in the air with this, but I'm definitely very curious to see what Analog is doing next because I think they're a fantastic company with a great track record. And after the success of things like the Mega SG, I definitely want to see them tackle other systems. So what do you think the Analog Pocket is going to be? Do you think it's going to be a Game Boy system? Let me know in the comments down below. Next up, it's always doom and gloom when it comes to GameStop. They're going under, they're gonna crash any day now, and everyone seems to be happy about this but me. I don't want GameStop to go away. Yes, GameStop does a lot of things wrong. Yes, when I worked at GameStop, I did not have a great time working at GameStop, but still, I like being able to go to a video game store to purchase video games and being able to look at video game products and maybe learn about video games that I did not know about. One thing that a lot of people have been wanting to do is having GameStop expand their in-store games and of course include retro. Now when I worked at GameStop, they were actually phasing out retro stuff. The PS1, N64, we had shelves of that stuff and they marked everything down. So, I mean, I of course bought it all. But of course now they've completely phased out retro stuff in the store, just focusing on more modern systems. But as the times are changing and GameStop is seeing, you know, a shrinking in their client base and a shrinking in their sales and of course their stocks are going down, they're now looking to embrace retro once again. Now you might remember a few years ago, I did a video talking about how you should not buy games from GameStop in the retro market because of what they were doing with their online store. They weren't checking anything. They were selling fake Sculptor's Cuts. There was a blue Sculptor's Cut game on the N64, and it's like, that didn't exist. That's not a real thing. So I was definitely very speculative and very hesitant to give GameStop my business when it came to buying retro games. But if you're talking about in-store stuff, that's completely different. You can actually look at the product. You can feel the product in your hand. And Spawnwave got some pictures sent over to him from a viewer of his channel where their GameStop location is now actually selling retro products in their store. And yes, I asked Spawnwave if I can use these pictures. People have this weird thing that Spawnwave and I don't talk every day. We literally talk every day, and I clear things with him if I want to use his stuff. So I don't know where that weird notion comes from. But what's actually very interesting about GameStop's in-store retro stuff is it's priced good. Like, these are good prices on things. So let's go over some of these pictures real quick and talk about the prices. So you can see they have a selection of different NES, Super Nintendo, N64, few GameCube, and some Game Boy games here. And honestly, these prices are pretty fair for a lot of these things. Looking at Contra, $25. If you have a power-up card, it's only $22. You know, Mario 2 for $10. You look at some of the Super Nintendo stuff, Star Fox for $10. Mario All-Stars for $15. Of course, these prices are lower if you have their power-up card. The N64 stuff, you know, Star Fox for $20. Like, these are not bad prices. Diddy Kong Racing for $20. Super Mario Brothers 3 on the Game Boy Advance for $12. You got some GameCube games here as well. You have Simpsons Hit and Run, which is actually a highly sought after game, as the GameCube version does have the progressive scan mode in it. You know, that's only $25. And the nice thing about this is you can see the product. You can hold the product. And you can see, is this going to be a complete in-box game if it's a disc game? Obviously, if it's a disc game, you don't have to worry about counterfeiting and things like that. If it's a lower end retro cartridge game, you probably don't have to worry about things like counterfeiting. But you can always bring a tool with you and open it up and just look really quick. I'm sure most GameStop employees wouldn't really care about that because you're not really damaging anything. You're just looking at the actual board. But this is what GameStop needs to do. This is what GameStop needs to do in order to stay relevant in the video game marketplace. Have some of these retro games available to pick up in store. So that way I can look at the condition of the cartridge. I can look at the condition of the disc and not have to play a guessing game. Because when you buy things from GameStop's online website, of course, you're simply playing a guessing game. You don't know what that game is going to look like in terms of quality. With Walmart doing so many weird decisions when it comes to video games right now, GameStop can actually capitalize on something like this and make people want to go back to their store. Do I think GameStop will go to the prominence era that they once were? Of course not, but this is something that can help them stay alive and help them stay relevant in the video game marketplace. So I am all for this. I would like to see GameStop expand this to all of their stores, because I would love to be able to go to my local GameStop right down the street and check out some retro games right alongside of my modern games as well. And finally, it looks like a big Nintendo Switch game that I think a lot of people have forgotten is supposed to come to the Nintendo Switch will be coming to us very, very soon. Now, I honestly thought when this game was announced that this was going to be the Steep of 2019. You might remember when the Nintendo Switch was first unveiled, Steep from Ubisoft was supposed to come to the Nintendo Switch, and then it was quietly canceled. So when this game was shown off very briefly at E3 2019, I said, you know what, I would buy this again on day one, as I already own it on the Xbox One, but I don't think it's ever going to come out. I'm sure that they're going to run into some technical problems with this game, and we probably will never see it. But now an ESRB rating has been done for this game, so people are anticipating that this game will be coming in a matter of weeks now, as that's when they tend to do ESRB ratings. And that game is Alien Isolation. Now, what makes Alien Isolation a big game for the Nintendo Switch is a multitude of things. First and foremost, Alien Isolation is fantastic. It is arguably one of the best stealth games and one of the best horror games in the past decade. It created such a tension with this alien trying to hunt you down and you trying to survive on this spaceship. Just an absolutely fantastic game. I played it to death on the Xbox One and I absolutely loved it. So Switch owners are getting a fantastic game when it comes to Alien Isolation. But the bigger thing to me about Alien Isolation is I don't think this is a game that should necessarily work on the Nintendo Switch. This to me is sort of like bringing Doom over to the Nintendo Switch. How are they going to make this work? Because Alien Isolation, of course, was designed with the PS4, Xbox One, and PC in mind. There was no last generation version of this, so they couldn't do something like, you know, a Skyrim and just change the textures up to make this game work on the Nintendo Switch. This was a big budget third party game that is now coming to the Nintendo Switch that really looked really good graphically. There was a lot of nice graphical effects. The alien animations themselves were absolutely fantastic, much better than the CGI than we've seen in recent Alien movies. So to me, this is a big game that is sort of flying under the radar. As a fan of horror games and stealth games, I was absolutely ecstatic to see that this was coming to the Nintendo Switch, but I really felt like this was going to be the steep of 2019 for Nintendo Switch. Now, we have seen some Nintendo Switch ports just get absolutely botched, but with the recent games coming out, like The Outer Worlds now confirmed for the Nintendo Switch, it seems like developers are actually putting in more time and effort to make Switch ports work. And because of the way that the Switch is selling, this could be an absolutely fantastic addition to the Nintendo Switch. I hope that it comes out before Halloween. I think this would be a great 1-2 punch with something like Alien Isolation, Luigi's Mansion 3, and the upcoming Friday the 13th, which actually comes out tomorrow, August 13th. And it could be a great time for fans who like a spooky adventure on the Nintendo Switch. So it looks like Alien Isolation is coming soon. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, this is a definite double dip for me. I definitely want to check out the Nintendo Switch version from a technical perspective. And if the game runs well, Nintendo Switch owners are definitely in for a very, very big treat. All right, so those are three stories that I wanted to cover in today's video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. So let me know in the comment section down below what you think of all this news. What do you think Analog is doing with the Analog Pocket and the Analog 8? Is this going to be Game Boy and N64 like everyone is hoping, or could it potentially be something else? What do you think of GameStop selling retro games in store, and would you like to see this expand this to more stores so that your local GameStop will have retro stuff as well, and do you think this will actually help the company out? And of course, are you looking forward to Alien Isolation on the Nintendo Switch? Is this a game that's on your radar? Did you check it out on other platforms? And if so, are you going to double dip? And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. Check out other videos on the channel. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Later.